Hi, I understand there's some questions regarding formatting on assignment 4, so I thought I'd walk you through this for a minute. Pay no attention to the numbers on this screen since I've re-randomized them all, but let's just focus on the formatting. These cells down here are all numbers, but I want the commas in there, but unfortunately if you hit the comma button up above, it turns it into accounting. So then a lot of you are going here and adjusting the decimal places down, but now look, these numbers are shifted in the bottom row a little bit to the left because accounting forces you to put some parentheses around it. And right now the parentheses are just invisible, so it creates this weird custom formatting thing, which is just nasty looking and confusing. So let's show you how to do this and keep it consistent with how we've been doing things all semester. So let me undo this and throw it back to the way it was when we started the video. All right, so all these numbers here, they're all quantities. They're numbers of cars sold. They're not dollar amounts. So I just want to format them as a number. So I'm going to come in here, click on number, zero decimal places, use the commas, and notice there's no parentheses around those negative numbers now. And they are all lined up on the right margin. Now these are all dollar amounts. Well, at least these here are dollar amounts. Row 30 is some quantities, but we'll get into that in a minute. So since they're dollars amount, I want them to be currency. So I'm going to come over here, click on this little widgety thing, change it to currency, zero decimal places. But I'm going to leave the dollar sign in there for the time being. But unfortunately, it puts dollar signs all throughout that. And I won't need to take those out. So I'm going to go back in and just take the dollar sign out and hit OK. And then notice this becomes a number. And that's okay. It's still currency, just without a dollar sign. And Excel just shows it as a number. All right, so now I want these cells to be formatted just like these cells. So I use the Format Painter to make the formatting exactly the same. And then I'm going to take the bold out of those bottom ones, because I don't ask you for those to be bold. And that's really it for the formatting on assignment 4. So some of you are having issues with the conditional formatting over here in column P, so let's take a look at that for a minute. Ultimately, we want, if it says Excel, it should be green. If it's good, it should be yellow. If it's poor, it should be pink. So if we take a look at the conditioning formatting rule, you always use this equal to rule. And after you make it, it should look something like this. Cell value equals poor, equals good, equals excellent for those range of cells. And that's really it. That's how you want it to be. Don't use the text that contains. Use equal to. All right? Have a great day.